Padlet is a virtual bulletin board application that you can use as an alternative to traditional discussions. Padlet is a great tool if you want to give learners a more visual experience when it comes to interacting with each other and going through course content. Now there's different types of Padlets that you can make, different types of templates, if you will. And I want to showcase some of those for you right now. So the first type that we're looking at right here is what we call a wall template. With a wall, you can have students make contributions, and the posts kind of fit together like bricks in a wall, basically. So in this example, we have students who have shared some text along with hyperlinks to different websites. Another type is the Canvas. Now, this is not to be confused with Canvas, the learning management system. Canvas is another type of Padlet that you can make. Similar to the wall, a Canvas allows you to post different images or text wherever you want, as opposed to having the posts stacked up right next to each other. So in this example, we can see using Padlet as an image board. But you can actually do a lot with the Canvas type. Here's actually another Canvas Padlet. This one, again, we can put different pieces of content wherever. However, with this one, we're actually using connectors to establish relationships. So this is another cool feature of the Canvas type of Padlet. In addition to that, we have the stream style of Padlet, which is basically kind of like a blog. You have a single column that goes down the center. So if that's the type that you want to make, they have that available. The grid is very similar to the wall type in that it stacks posts next to each other, but does it in a slightly more organized format. So everything has its own column and row. I should point out that with the example that we're looking at here, you'll notice that there's the ability to upvote and downvote posts. And in this case, they're using that functionality to indicate true or false. This is an option that's available with Padlet, is that you can allow for posts to have upvote, downvote. You can allow them to have likes, and you can also allow them to be starred from 1 to 5. So you can give post ratings as well. Another type that's really cool is the shelf style of Padlet. And with shelf, essentially what happens is when you create the Padlet, you can decide what you want these headers or shelves to be at the top of the screen. And then people can go in and post under the shelves that you have created. And so I can scroll through here and look at the individual posts that people have provided under each of these shelves. So this is a great way to perhaps categorize information. Another type of Padlet is the map Padlet, in which you determine what type of a map you want, like what part of the world you want. You can do some customization with regards to color as well. And then students could go in and post to individual points on the map. So this is a great labeling activity if there's some geographic topic that you are discussing in your course. The last one I want to highlight is the timeline. The timeline allows you to plot points along a line. Now, you certainly could use it as a timeline to represent time. However, you can also use it just to organize content in a series. So the timeline is a pretty cool style of Padlet as well. Now, those are the different types of Padlets that we have available. However, in addition to the different types of Padlets, we also want to take a look at, well, what can students actually post within a Padlet? And there's actually quite a bit that students can post. So let me jump over to an example here and I'll show you what they can do. So here I am in a Padlet, and you'll see that in the lower right corner, I have this little plus symbol where I can post. I can make a new post to this Padlet. When I click on that, the default things that it gives me at first is to type in a title. So I give a title of my post, and then down below I can put some text in the text box. Okay. Now, I could leave it at that and just have it be a text post, and I can click out of it to kind of finish my post. However, I'll go back and hit the pencil to edit it again. In addition to text, we can do a lot of other stuff. So we can do file uploads. So if we want to upload an attachment, we can do that. We can provide a hyperlink to another website. We can do an image search. So if I click on this one, I can actually search for different topics. So maybe I'll search for my dog breed. There we go. And I can put an image in there as well. In addition to images, we can do a quick snapshot using our webcam or phone. And also there's other things that we can do. We can include videos and post videos to our Padlet. We can do audio recordings. We can do screen recordings. We can do drawings, kind of like a virtual whiteboard. We can indicate a place on a map, and we can link to another Padlet. So there's actually a lot of stuff that you can post to a Padlet. And that's one of the benefits of it, is that it's very multimedia rich in what it can accommodate. So how do you actually get started with using Padlet? Well, first of all, it's important to keep in mind that we at CVTC have an account-wide license of Padlet, which means as soon as you get into your CVTC account, you can start making as many Padlets as you want. Now, this is different from making a free account at Padlet.com, which does have some restrictions on it. So to access your CVTC Padlet account, here's what you can do. First of all, make sure that you're logged into My CVTC. That's an important first step. Once you're logged into MyCVTC, let's go up to the address bar and just type in cvtc.padlet.org. And when you go there, you'll be presented with this screen right here. Now, don't type in your email and password down below. Instead, click on this Login with Microsoft button. The reason we're doing that is because everyone at CVTC automatically has a Microsoft account. And since we logged into MyCVTC, it's going to be able to recognize who we are. So I'll click on that. It might ask you for your CVTC email. If so, you can type it in. But once you do that, it should bring you into your Padlet dashboard. And from here, you're able to start creating new Padlets. Now, there's more information with regards to how to actually make Padlets and set up the different share permissions and settings, and I'll cover that in my next video. Thanks for watching.